Has it been a year already? God, it felt like five.
LRP.
All right, so
it felt like five.
All right, so the anniversary of the Zepp train wreck isn't actually until tomorrow, but typical guy that I am, I'm going hunting and fishing on our anniversary.
Yeah.
The anniversary of Prince's death. That was quite a day last year, so I thought I'd sneak that in there for you. That's all I got you, by the way.
You know, I was but thank you, because it was awesome to hear that, and I was surprised. I was a little surprised the governor declared it Prince Day tomorrow, but not anything about us. Not a damn word our anniversary.
Maybe he's saving it for prime time tonight.
Maybe.
Probably going to make a big State of the Union address. Terri, we've got one more pair of KQ Suite tickets for Def Leppard, Poison, and Tesla. Of course, at the Excel tomorrow night, we're going to debut a little game we call Musical Chairs.
This is going to be so much fun. So
if it works.
We've talked about it for like a year.
Man.
And we're going to unveil it today.
And it'll run it right off the tracks, as we typically do. We'll do that about 5:40, Terri.
It can't be worse than our animal pet sound thing we did.
I hope not.
Also at 5:20, cheap, trashy showbiz news, all the latest gossip and dirt and garbage about your celebrities.
After ZZ Top, we got a story about another Minnesota guy that tried to hire a cop to kill someone.
What are the odds
that he wouldn't, actually? It's a one-hit wonder day. You get it 420, Terri. You see what we're doing there?
I see what you're doing there.
On
very clever.
On 420, we're dropping in some one-hit wonders and kicking it off with one of my favorites. Although I don't know if he's a one-hit wonder, but I'm playing it anyway. Dr. John, right place.
Oh, great sign.
Wrong time.
Yeah. Zepp and Terri.
Hey.
This
is so ironic. Just the other night, I saw a naked cowgirl crawling across my ceiling. I really appreciate you guys playing this.
You did see a naked cowgirl crawling across your ceiling.
I did. You know me, Zeph.
Yeah, they do call you dopey, and it is 420.
Well, all right. I appreciate that.
Thanks for the call. People celebrating already. I guess it is happy hour. Terri, serious news here from KSTP-TV website. An Anoka County man faces charges after attempting to hire someone to kill a man he was having a bad business dispute with, according to court records. If only he could get away with that. According to a criminal complaint in November, 62-year-old Kevin Patrick Condren hired an individual to do paralegal work. During the meetings with the man, Condren asked if he ever did side jobs, you know, like killing people. He later offered the individual $5,000 and a revolver to kill the victim. How's that just come up in conversation? Oh, never mind. Condren called the man again 10 days later and offered $10,000, according to the complaint. The man then went to police out of fear that Condren may harm the victim. Arrangements were later made to have Condren meet with an undercover detective. Of course, the complaint said Condren met with the undercover detective in December at a restaurant and explained he wanted the victim dead because of a $150,000 business dispute. That's a lot of money. Condren offered the undercover officer up to $7,000 to kill the man, but asked him to wait until August of 2017 because he would be moving to Vietnam. Condren and the undercover officer met again in late December. So law enforcement issued a warrant for Condren on Monday of this week on a probable cause of conspiracy to commit murder charge based on multiple attempts to hire someone to murder the victim. The Anoka County jail log shows that he was arrested and jailed yesterday. So
he was, first he offered $5,000, then he upped it to $10,000, and then he backed off to $7,000.
Yeah, well,
he's just trying to squeeze any way he can.
Well, he's got to move to Vietnam and that budget. Plus, he might have lost, we don't know about the $150,000 business dispute. He might have been out a couple of bucks on that.
So imagine, Zepp, let's just say a restaurant. Yeah. Imagine you're at Perkins.
Yeah, I can imagine that.
And you hear a conversation like that.
Mm-hmm.
What do you do? Do you just keep eating your French soap pie, or do you?
Well, it's 2017. I pick up my telephone and I slyly try and record them so I can YouTube it later.
Bizarre.
I just love that he had this. Let me go back to the story. I shouldn't go back to the story, but just real quick. During meetings with the man, he hired an individual to do paralegal work.
Yeah.
During those meetings, he asked him if he ever did side jobs and told the man he wanted another man killed. So you hired a paralegal and thought, well, maybe this is the right guy
for the job. Maybe he looks shady.
The old shady paralegal. Speaking of shady, how about cheap and trashy, Terri?
Oh, yeah. We have it.
All right. We'll do it after one from Triumph. Bowie, now on KQ. Triumph on KQ92.
Speaking of triumph, here's your cheap, trashy showbiz news for Thursday.
And the agony of defeat.
I know. In a gathering of the most famous conservative personalities and entertainers in the country, former Alaska Governor Sarah Palin. Now, look, listen to this group. Musicians Kid Rock and Ted Nugent dined at the White House with Trump Wednesday night, the president.
I'd like to try and get a word in on that. Sarah Palin, Kid Rock, and Ted Nugent. I wonder what they were talking about. Probably still all tore up after the defeat of Hillary Clinton.
Well, looky here, boogie chillin'. I got your shot heard round the world right here in big old greasy Washington, D.C., where your one and only Motor City madman, whackmaster, strap assassin, one, dined with President Donald J. Trump at the White House to make America great again. Got that?
No.
Who put that on Facebook?
That clearly was
the Nuge.
Ted.
Yeah. Yes,
Uncle Teddy.
Here are some celebs who are kissing cousins. Hillary Clinton, Ellen DeGeneres, and Madonna. They're all 10th cousins. I don't know if that even counts, does it? 10th cousin?
Aren't we all 10th cousins?
I think so. Al Roker and Lenny Kravitz are cousins. Kate Middleton, Elle, and Dakota Fanning are descendants of King Edward III. But Kate is actually more related to her husband. You know how the royals are.
Yeah.
Snoop Dogg, Brandy, and Ray J are related. The rapper is first cousins with those famous siblings. Amy and Chuck Schumer are distant cousins. Prince Charles and Ralph Fiennes are cousins. And Halle Berry and Sarah Palin. Isn't that weird? What an odd couple.
I'm losing track.
Prince's new album has been yanked off of iTunes while the court battle begins. This could take a while.
Yeah,
I drove
think.
By Paisley Park the other day. It was packed with cars. But they need a better way to display the mementos. It just doesn't look that great.
Well, the people are still leaving there, I imagine.
Yeah, there's like a fence. They need a really nice thing. And Bill O'Reilly met with the Pope, but it was not enough to save his job. At 20 to 25 mil a year, he'll eat by.
I hate you.
And,
yeah, he will eat by, won't he?
There's your cheap trashy.
Fizzling
out.
Hey, I got a question. How do you get on that game show you're going to have?
Oh, yeah, we're calling it Musical Chairs. We have one last pair of sweet tickets for Def Leppard, Poison, and Tesla tomorrow night. So what we'll do here at about 10 minutes, right after the break, we'll do traffic and weather, and then Terri and I will take, what do you think, 3 callers, and then we'll explain the Musical Chairs game involving Def Leppard music.
You'll say when to call in to get on it, though?
Oh, yeah. We'll do it right after the break. Hey, make sure you join Ray Eric in celebrating Earth Day Saturday at Home Depot in Maplewood. He's going to be there from 10 to noon with Pennington One Step Complete Smart Seed, and your chances at a $100 gift card with Ray Eric. That's Saturday at Home Depot in Maplewood from 10 to noon. Terri, it's 420, so we're playing One Hit Wonders on KQ. Oh, you know, because it is 420, I left cookies and milk out for Willie Nelson last night.
Oh, did you?
Yeah, they were gone this morning.
That was nice of you, Zepp.
I had a bellyache, so
you're
I'm not sure.
You're always thinking.
Our next hit wonder coming up here pretty soon.
Well, the traffic is, you know, the traffic. 394 eastbound between Louisiana and 94 is heavy if you're heading eastbound and westbound. Also heavy traffic on 94 eastbound between 394 and 35W. Heavy traffic there as well.
Oh, I see.
651 Carpets. Purchase your favorite carpet and everything is free. Free furniture moving, free step installation, free standard pad, free installation, and up to 24-month interest-free financing. 651 Carpets. That's our name, number, and online, 651carpets.com.
Well, the weather is, you know, the weather.
Yeah.
I'm mocking you, actually. Your KQ weather from VillageChev.com. I shouldn't have to point that out. Clearing up later tonight, 35, and then a stretch of beautiful weather just when you want it on the weekend. Sunny and 62 tomorrow, sunny and 65 on Saturday, and about the same on Sunday. 50 right now. Okay, now we'll take 3 callers. Caller number 5, caller number 10, caller number 15. If you're willing to sit on hold for a few minutes, you'll be playing Musical Chairs for sweet tickets in the KQ Suite.
This is so exciting.
Yeah, that's usually
please
the kiss.
Please work.
It's One Hit Wonders today on KQ92, the 5-man electrical band on KQ. Did I say that already?
Is this science?
Yeah, it is so good. It's Led Zeppelin on the Zepp Train Wreck, KQ92. We might get this sucker right off the rails now. Giving away a pair of Def Leppard, Poison, and Tesla tickets in KQ Suite tomorrow. A little game we call Musical Chairs, and let's hope this works. All right, we'll go to line number 5 here. This would be...
Line number 5 is Sarah from Plato, Minnesota, originally from Watertown.
All right, Sarah, you there?
Yes, I am.
All right, Sarah. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to play a Def Leppard song, probably one of their best-known songs, and you just be listening along, singing the lyrics in your head. As soon as you hear the music stop, much like musical chairs, instead of sitting down, you just finish the few words of that verse. Not going to be a long verse. You'll know it when you hear it, and as soon as I stop it, just finish the words, okay?
Okay, that sounds fine.
And we also have a couple other people on hold. Now, if you win, they're SOL. So we'll give it a shot here. Hopefully this works. Gosh, I hope all you right. can hear this. Here we go. Can you hear that?
Yep, I could hear that.
All right. Oh, good. All right, here we go. You know, watch the night go up in smoke. Very sorry. Do we have consolation prizes? We do not. I thought it might be a little tougher than that. Congratulations, Sarah. You've got yourself a couple of tickets and KQ Suite.
Yay,
Sarah.
Yeah. All right, Sarah, hang on. Don't go anywhere.
The other two just want to play for the pride.
We'll go break the bad news to them. I thought it might take longer than that.
I did, too.
I think it was about 13 or 14, but I know you absolutely did not get a kiss if you didn't own that cassette, REO Speedwagon, on KQ92 with Zepp and Terri. I think we made that musical chairs too easy. I'm sure the other contestants... we're just like, what? Anybody could get that. Well, I was worried that it was going to be too hard and we're going to be sitting there for 10 minutes.
You went to tell Nate sorry and he had already hung up.
Now Samantha hung up.
Oh, Samantha.
But thanks for hanging. We'll make it a little tougher next time because that was kind of fun.
It was really fun. Maybe next time we'll have more prizes too, right. Rather than just one pair. Sorry.
Well, Terri, we do love to go through our listener mail.
Yes.
So send it in. Any old thing that crosses your mind, it doesn't matter what it is. What am I thinking of? Oh, 92kqrs.com. Click on the On Air tab, and you can message Zepp and Terri, which is different than entering our well-played moments. If you want a Mystic prize pack, I think $50 in free slots in there.
Yeah, we have some good letters in there, too.
So you took a bad moment, yeah. And you...
you made a chicken salad out of chicken, shat.
Exactly. Took a bad situation and made it better. Then you want to scroll down until you see that purple Zepp and Terri Mystic Well Played Moments, and you could enter there just like this person did. Here's another Well Played Moment winner from Club M at Mystic Lake.
This is from Daryl Kukowski of East Bethel. Hi, Zepp and Terri. Longtime listener here. Back in my single days, my roommate wanted to go to a bar, but I just wanted to wash and wax my car. He ended up talking me into going with the old tactic. He was interested in this babe and needed a wingman. So we went out, met a couple of girls, talked and danced, and had cocktails. They agreed to leave with us and have breakfast at our house. Wow. My friend ended up having a one-night stand. The other girl and I just celebrated our 25th wedding anniversary.
Sounds like everybody won. Thanks for sharing your story, Daryl. That was indeed a well-played moment. Just like being a Club M at Mystic Lake member is full of well-played moments. And if, like Daryl, you'd like to win a Mystic Lake prize, and look for Zepp and Terri's Well-Played Moments contest. Club M, entertainment well-played, only at Mystic Lake.
What a great hour we have for you. Don't leave us. Do not leave us in the 6 o'clock hour after Fleetwood.
I thought we talked about overselling.
We did. After Fleetwood Mac, your listener letters, we're going to read those. And also Psychic Maria Shaw coming up later on in the hour.
Cool. Some classic rock. Don't forget some one-hit wonders coming up, celebrating 420, I guess, in our geeky way. This nonstop free ride brought to you by Whiting Clinic LASIK and Eye Care. There she goes, Stevie Zepp. Stevie Nicks, sorry. Daydreaming there. It's the Zepp train wreck on KQ92. Some listener letters. Thanks. You can send them in at 92kqrs.com. Click on the On Air tab and shoot us any old thing on your mind. Maria from Eden Prairie. Hi, Terri. What's the name of that landscaping company you do commercials for? The one with no payments and interest for 12 months. Eek, I hope that's I hope they have that offer. Who is that, Terri?
They do have that offer. It's Spears Landscape, S-P-E-A-R-S, mm-hmm. Landscape. And Jeff Spears owns it. In fact, he's listening right now. Jeff, they never miss the show.
Jeff, we're billing you for this.
Thank you, and they do beautiful work. So if you're looking for landscaping, make sure you check them out. Just go to their website. Nope. S-P-E-A-R apostrophe S Landscape.
All right, sounds good.
All right. This is from Denise in Chaska. Hi, Terri. I saw this headline and thought it was a funny news story. Oh, here we go. I haven't pre-read this. A Mason City man who called 911 to report a burglary at his house was arrested. What? When the officers found several bags of marijuana, but no burglar inside his home.
So wait, a burglar broke in, left several bags of marijuana.
And then broke back out.
I doubt it.
Trey Ritchie, age 23, was charged with felony possession of marijuana with intent to deliver a felony drug tax stamp violation.
Where is this?
In Iowa?
Mason City, Iowa. But pot's not legal. Why do you have to have a tax stamp for pot? I could see in Colorado.
I don't know. And also misdemeanor possession of drug paraphernalia. Richie called police at about 7:25 in the morning on Sunday because he heard noises and thought someone was breaking into his residence. Officers dispatched to investigate the alleged burglary found no sign that anyone had tried to force their way in, but smelled pot and found drug paraphernalia. He got paranoid. Investigators also saw several large bags of marijuana, a box of plastic bags, and a digital scale. Well, prove it with marijuana on it, all in plain view.
Sounds like a good place to burgle.
So he got paranoid, called the cops.
He might want to.
He turned himself in.
Hey, man. Am I driving okay?
I think we're parked, man.
All right. Well, thanks for sending that one in. That's a good one for 420. Here's one from Roy in St. Paul. I was listening to your show about strange names. A coworker of mine had to email a guy overseas about some stuff period. The guy overseas, his name was... All right. Well, that's all right.
That's
okay. I didn't proofread this one either. His name is Richard Peterlick. No joke. I saw the emails. Oh, Dick Peterlick. It rolls off the tongue, you gotta say. Yeah, that's where mom and dad, what are you thinking?
You have to spell that every time then, too?
Perhaps.
Could you spell that?
Maybe they were stoned.
I'm exhausted.
All that air drumming.
I just love the yodeling.
Right, celebrating 420 with one-hit wonders. Yeah, Terri, that was a one-of-a-kind band, not just a one-hit wonder. Dutch yodeling rockers, Focus with Hocus Pocus, and because we are KQRS and not some pussy classic hit station, we gave you the entire 6 minutes and 38 seconds of that bad boy. Okay, your chance to get some questions into our psychic Maria Shaw coming up a little bit later.
Yeah, I'll be taking them. And after Steppenwolf, Foley cops are on the lookout for a McRobber with Zepp and Terri on KQ.
Aerosmith. Hell yeah, got good motorcycling weather this weekend.
At last, finally, huh?
Yeah.
Well, Foley cops are seeking the public's help. If you know of anything, please call them. They're locating a female suspect after attempting to rob a McDonald's last night at 7:20. A woman had entered McDonald's and asked to speak with the manager. When she talked with him, she then advised him to empty out the safe for her. The manager refused and offered her food or drinks instead.
Well, I might try that myself.
It's so cute because it's in Foley. The woman then threatened to kill everyone in the store multiple times.
All right.
She did not show a firearm, and before she left, she joked about it and said she was a reporter. Then left on foot. She may have left in a white car. She's in her mid-30s with curly hair, wearing blue jeans, a purple sweatshirt with a pink shirt underneath of it, and sunglasses.
Sounds like somebody over at Fox 9.
The Foley police do not believe the public is in danger, and you're asked to call them. So she left on foot, and no one nabbed her.
So probably drunk or just kind of a whack job, and because the McDonald's manager went, okay, how about we get you something to eat?
Isn't that kind of almost cute? Like, here, how about a hamburger and Coke?
Somebody needs a Happy Meal.
I know.
Why don't we get you something to eat?
Off the dollar menu.
I'm going to kill everybody. No, you're not.
Maybe a cone.
Yeah, right. All right, Terri, let's take some phone calls. Maria Shaw, our guest, psychic, calling in. So they just need to Call us, 651-989-ROCK or ROLL. Terri will answer the phones and walk you through it and take your question and all that good information. 651-989-ROCK or ROLL.
I'm manning the phones.
There she goes.
Here's another well-played moment winner from Club M at Mystic Lake.
From Bob Masterson in Golden Valley. A couple of years ago, I was at Mystic Lake playing slots on a Friday when my slot machine gave me the blue screen of death. Just a malfunction, nasty error message. I hit cash out, took my ticket, told the attendant, and went home. A couple of days later, I got a message from Mystic Lake asking me to call them. Well, I thought I was in trouble for breaking the machine, so I waited and called back the next Friday. When I did, they asked if I was there last week and if I was on a machine that got an error message. I got a little scared, but said yes. Then they said the reason it malfunctioned was because I won the jackpot and the machine didn't know how to tell me, so my mediocre night turned into a $45,000 weekend.
Whoa.
Lesson learned. Always use your player's card in the machine or they'll never track you down.
Yeah, wow, Bob. Thanks for sharing your story. That was indeed a well-played moment. Just like being a Club M at Mystic Lake member is full of well-played moments. Club M, entertainment well-played only at Mystic Lake.
Your KQ weather from VillageChev.com. Clearing 35 tonight. Tomorrow going to be sunny and 62 and sunny through the weekend in the 60s. Enjoy that. It's 49 now. Terri Train taking your calls for our psychic Maria Shaw coming up in about 12 or 13 minutes. 651-989-ROCK or ROLL. There's a one-hit wonder.
Wow.
KQ celebrates 420 with vehicle there. Traffic on KQ92. Did I get that right? Oh, Ides of March, sorry.
Yeah, Ides of March.
With vehicle. I went on traffic there. All right, we'll do Maria Shaw, our guest after Def Leppard. Journey now. There go the Stones on the old Zepp train wreck, KQ92. Can I call it old after 1 year? Doesn't feel like it's getting old. 648 right now, Maria Shaw, our guest. Probably about every other Thursday, if I'm starting to pick up on the pattern here.
For like almost a year. Hi, Maria.
Hi, Terri. How you doing?
Oh, good. I'm losing my voice. I don't know. It's weird. It's starting to fade out. How are you?
I'm doing fantastic. I'm trying to fight with this Mercury retrograde. It's been a crazy day. People forgetting things, miscommunication.
Oh, but I thought that was the newest strain of pot. It's called Mercury retrograde.
But hey, what you're supposed to do is just relax.
Yeah.
Just
relax.
Nothing. Just relax. Have I permission to do nothing?
All right. Thank you.
I'm going to do that while we... Terri, you answered a bunch of phone calls. MariaShaw.com, by the way, where you can find this lovely lady.
Yes. Now, we have a whole list of questions, so you got to keep it rolling here, Maria. Sherry, 71754, will she retire soon?
Within the next 2 years.
Okay, that's good. Chris, 121259, will he win any golf tourneys?
Oh, he's, June and late July look good.
Okay. Nicholas, 61081, job, career, how's that looking?
Better in the fall.
Greg, 121461. Will he marry again? And if so, should it be Terri or Susan?
Terri, are you available?
let's see how this weekend goes.
Okay. You know, he doesn't really want to get married on one level.
Yeah.
There's a part of him that really doesn't want to. So I'm going to say he's just going to string women along. He's going to have a lot of friends.
It sounds like he is with the Terri or Susan. Tom from Wayzata, this is a really interesting one, Maria. 1763 is his birthday, but his ex-brother-in-law went missing back in 1994. No one knows where he is. Do you?
Oh, my goodness. I think he claimed a different identity, and he's living somewhere else. I don't necessarily think he's passed.
Oh, okay. Wow. Susan, will she remarry? 122366.
Wasn't that guy looking for a Susan?
He was. We should hook her up with Greg.
Oh, that's right. Because you've got the, now we've got the Terri, we've got the Susan.
Yeah.
Let's make a love match off the air. You know, she's got the option to, but she's too damn picky sometimes.
Okay, because she's only 5 years older than him.
Lower your standard. Lower your standard, Susan.
Susan, quit being picky. Just take one. Go to farmersonly.com. You don't have to be lonely.
Farmhands. Let me tell you, I had a client from Minnesota that said, I went on there, all they're looking is for farmhands, for workers.
I shook a hand of a guy today. I swear to God, the man must have milked cows at some point. He had the thickest fingers I've ever touched.
Well, that's why Dad used to tell us that he had kids. Free labor.
Free labor, you're damn right. Diane, 61064, daughter, will she get married? She's autistic. She has a prospect, but what do you think?
I think the prospect is falling for her pretty quickly here, but I don't see any marriage for about 2 years.
Okay. Jerry, 10358, do you like Brewer and Shipley? One Toke Over the Line. Do you like the song?
I'll let you guys answer that one.
All right. I'm going to say yes, you do. Bill, 7:30:59. Oh, this is the one you got right, Maria. You told him by the 15th his old sweetheart from way back when would come back. She's back.
And
they're
pissed.
Hooking up by the 15th.
Good. Hooking up.
So you had that right. He asked you that 2 weeks ago.
Oh, my goodness. Well, congratulations and have fun while it lasts.
Of course you got it right.
While it lasts. Why? Is that?
Uh-oh.
Uh-oh. Rock-roll.
Enjoy the honeymoon.
Kathy, 9762, will she have a good summer?
Yes, because there's more money involved.
Good. Ellie, 31685, going to meet a guy. Where should she go to meet a guy? She lives in West St. Paul.
You guys know the streets and the towns better than I do, but her best time to meet someone and give her timing is going to be the latter part of June and the month of July.
Okay. Terri, 72251, will everything work out for her retirement in August?
Yeah, but she's going to, believe it or not, she thinks she's not going to miss it. She's going to miss it.
I like she's born in 71 and retiring soon. Good for you.
And Jennifer, 13173, does she know the man she's going to marry?
Nope. She's actually going through her midlife crisis. She's going to be meeting a lot of men.
Ooh.
Oh.
Well.
Good for her.
Keeping that number away from Zepp.
Yeah, right? Give me that one.
No.
All right, ladies, MariaShaw.com. Maria, when are you coming to town?
Yeah.
I'll be in town on May 6th and 7th. Mm-hmm. On May 7th, we'll be at the Radisson in Roseville for our big psychic fun fair, 9 to 4. Please come out and see us, and have a wonderful week, everyone.
And our first year anniversary is tomorrow.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Oh, it's wonderful news.
Yeah, you've been with us most of the way. Thank you, Maria. We appreciate it. We'll talk to you soon.
All righty. Bye-bye.
Here's another well-played moment winner from Club M at Mystic Lake.
This is from Scott Zelmer of Inver Grove Heights. Listening to KQ92 one day, Zepp did a piece on how many men die needlessly every year because they're too stubborn to go to the doctor. I remember that one, Zepp.
Mm-hmm.
I took his advice, and turns out I needed a triple bypass.
What?
2 days later, I was in surgery. Zepp saved my life.
I'm a hero, Terri.
What?
Do I get the Club M prize pack?
No.
Well, thanks, Scott, for sharing your story. That was indeed a well-played moment. Just like being a Club M at Mystic Lake member is full of well-played moments. If you'd like to win a Mystic Lake prize, go to 92kqrs.com and find the Zepp and Terri Mystic Lake Well-Played Moment Contest. Club M, entertainment well-played, only at Mystic Lake.
Can I have your autograph?
Hey. Subject to credit approval, rebate by prepaid debit card. Other tire manufacturer rebate or offer cannot be combined with Ford Service credit card rebate or offer. See your participating Ford dealer for details through SIG purchase.
Oh, I'm hungry for pancakes. A waffle would do. All right, Terri, we're going to take tomorrow off.
Yeah.
There are turkeys to be shot and fish to be caught. And
happy, well, I'm coming in. I'm doing something with Jeff Spears tomorrow.
Oh, yeah. Spears Landscaping.
But,
Landscaping.
Happy anniversary, even though it's a sad day that Prince died. But,
it is, but
what do you do?
Been a good year, Terri. It's been a lot of fun.
Thank you.
Thanks for putting up with my
The State Fair was just a blast. And Vegas, and we had some good times.
Oh, acting like it's over.
Well.
Hang in there, kiddo.
What do you call a horny stoner? On 420, I had to.
Yeah, why are you looking at me? I don't know. What do you call a horny stoner?
A weed whacker.